If you can't afford to look human, you're going to the farm. It's as simple as that.
Do you have any idea how much it costs to have an entire family in glamour?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
The open arms.
Enjoy your stay.
Thanks, Bigby. And thanks for covering for me last time, too.
Bigby? How could you do this to me?
I guess I finally see you for who you are! Tell me who did it! Just tell me who did it! I know you know!
I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women?
But, you know...
Just take him, okay? Take Crane.
Well, this is a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the Queen.
Point bullets are a nasty business. The silver slug deformed and shredded on impact.
He'll be okay, though.
Hmm?
He'll be okay?
His internal organs are positively riddled. If I don't extract every single scrap of silver, he's liable to suffer some long-term toxicosis. Easy there. Try not to move. We can't keep meeting this way, old boy. I figured I'd be done before you were conscious. But there's little I can do for the pain. Just stay still and let me finish.
My arm?
Yes, very ugly. But not life-threatening. I can't say the same for these bullets peppered throughout your vital organs.
Please, Bigby, don't move it. Doctor!
Look, I'm a bit engaged saving his life at the moment. But if the fractured extremity concerns him that much, he can set it himself. Not bad. That'll do, I suppose. He's lucky to be alive. And he won't be next time if he keeps going like this. He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll listen to you.
I don't know about that.
Well, he should. There are limits to what even I can do.
It's not like I asked for this shit to happen.
Yes, but it's not like you actively discouraged it either. Excuse me, Miss White, but perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
I think I should stay, at least until he's out of the woods.
Believe me, Bigby couldn't be in better hands, and I need the space to work, so if you wouldn't mind, we'd appreciate the headroom.
Stick around, all right? I don't know if I trust this guy.
Oh, please, I could do this with my optic nerve severed. We'll be down in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
Hey, Doc, how much longer?
Colin, leave him be.
It's finished when it's finished.
'Cause I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin, you're not even supposed to be here right now.
Oh, really? Where am I supposed to be? I'm here to take care of my friend.
With what? Your hooves?
Could you please not distract the doctor while he has my chest cut open?
Yes, that would be helpful. There. All done.
Great.
This isn't a habit you should keep to, having visits with me. And, well, this time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue. Miss White, he'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
He knows what it means. It's just been an unusual couple of days.
I know, but please, don't give him the excuse. His body will eventually give out. Take care of him, please.
I will. He'll need rest, I assume?
Sleep, mostly. Just keep watch, and make sure he doesn't get into further altercations.
Snow has enough to deal with, Swinehart. I can take care of myself.
Clearly. Anyways, guard against, as they say. Miss White? Sheriff? Colin?
Swiney?
So, how do you, feel?
It's Bigby, Snow. He'll be okay. Hell, I've seen him take worse.
Not much worse.
Not as good as can be expected, I think.
So, not well then.
I'm glad you're not dead. You stopped breathing, you know, when you passed out or died, I guess. It kind of scared the hell out of me. I've never seen you like that. And when Swinehart arrived, you know him, he's never worried. And even he thought you were, I don't know, it was just awful.
And pretty hard to kill.
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong way.
Colin...
I'm just saying, I was worried about him is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
Well, I'll get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing? What's even happening out there? I mean, do you guys have like a plan or something? And who should I be asking? Should I be worried about the Crooked Man taking over? Or is Crane still the thing?
Snow's the boss. She'll know what's best for the community.
Thanks. The Crooked Man came out of the shadows for a reason. For him to attack us so blatantly like that. He either feels invincible or desperate.
Well, if those are my two options, I don't think I'd pick desperate.
What do you mean?
You traded Crane to save Bigby. I'm just saying... That's not exactly something you do when you're playing with house money.
So he called my bluff. It's not like I'm gonna let Bloody Mary just murder.
Yeah, thanks, Snow, for all that back there.
No problem.
Thanks? You're not pissed that Crane's flown the coop? Or that the Crooked Man thinks he's got Snow under his thumb?
We're all mad about it, Colin. But it's not like we had a strong choice in the matter.
What else could Snow do? If she didn't hand him over, my ass would be down the witching well. And Crane still would have been taken.
Okay, I'll take your word for it.
All I care about right now is... just what does the Crooked Man want out of this? I thought he was just a loan shark, but clearly he's operating in other circles. It can't just be about Crane, right? Getting him out of town? Is this all about the murders? Crane can't be useful to him anymore. So what could this have to do with Faith and Lily?
Crane was a puppet, and the Crooked Man worked the strings. This is all about control of Fabled Town.
But then what do prostitutes have to do with it? Lily? And Faith?
I don't know how it all works out yet, but I know it does. Somehow.
The Crooked Man declared war against us last night. At least that's what I thought when it happened. But now I see this war has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken. We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean, the right way?
What do you think I mean?
I don't know, but it suspiciously sounds like your way.
Yeah, wait, what do you mean? What is this right way?
We haven't been doing a good job. You and I. So, starting now, we do everything cut and dried, by the book, straight as an arrow.
Pure as driven snow.
I'm not saying I'm the arbiter of...
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen again.
We need monsters. To fight monsters.
Colin, if I really believed that we needed him to lose his flippin' mind at a moment's notice, then that would mean I'd lost all faith in our ability to help this town. Just let that side of you be done, okay? Be done and buried, and we can all move on. Look, Bigby, I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy. Everybody wants Bigby to smile and shave and take a shower now and then. Hell, I'm practically the president of the Bigby Don't Be Such a Dick Club. But this is the wrong fucking time to put shackles on him.
Relax, Colin. I can speak for myself, okay?
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to let you do it, okay? It's just that now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect. And this situation has to end.
What situation?
All unglamored fables starting today have to go and stay at the farm.
Oh, give me a fucking break. Are you gonna let her talk to me like that?
It's been the rule for a reason, Colin. And Bigby knows it's for the best of the town.
Look, everyone just calm down, all right?
I'm perfectly calm.
I'm not. Tell me right now, what's it gonna be, Bigby?
Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Oh, Buffkin, what is it? Okay, I'll let him know. Thanks. Guess who's waiting in your office right now? Narissa.
Narissa?
That broad from the Puddin' and Pie?
Yes. Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you. And what do you think that could be?
Bigby's got an admirer. You always do well with the, disenfranchised. Something about your prickly demeanor attracts him like a moth to a flame.
She knows something. She's helped me a little with the case. Maybe she has something else.
Maybe she does. I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long taking calls. And I should probably change out of these clothes. Consider the discussion tabled, but not over. Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain. She's a piece of work. Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you? I mean, she seemed real serious about it, but I can still hang out here, right?
I don't know. Snow'll come around. She's just... You know, the Crane thing hit her hard, and she doesn't really know who her friends are right now.
Oh, okay. I get it.
Don't worry about it.
Thanks, Bigby.
Hi, Sheriff.
Hi, Narissa. Have a seat.
Are you okay? You didn't look good last night. I wasn't sure you'd be, you know, around.
Let's just say I've been better.
Huff and Puffs. Not many people smoke those. Thanks.
So what was that back there with Crane? He wanted you to tell me something. You know, it's not too late to talk.
There's not a lot that I can talk about. You know that.
So that spell Crane was trying to break. It's not just while you're at work, huh?
What I mean is, I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want you wasting your own time either.
Back in the dressing room, at the pudding and pie, I told you what I was looking for, and you found a way to tell me. You sent me to the open arms. Maybe that'll work again?
You can try. I just... Go ahead. It might work.
You're here because the Crooked Man just sent Crane to the bottom of my list of worries. And you have something you want to say about that, right?
These lips are sealed. If I could answer you just like that, I wouldn't have had to make that appointment with you.
No, I guess not.
Sometimes, we have to find our way through life on our own, grasping and fumbling in the dark. I used to have friends to help me find my way, but now they're gone, and I don't know what to do.
Are you trying to say something about Faith and Lily?
What I'm saying is friends matter, and I don't have any left. So I hope you're looking after yours. Are you? Look around you.
Who are you talking about? Are my friends in danger?
I'm sorry. I thought I could do this. I need you to know I want to help, but...
It's okay. Take your time.
I'm sorry if I'm wasting your time. I thought I knew how to say it.
Ribbons. Faith wore one too, huh?
Do you like it? Do you?
I'm trying to help. I just don't know what I can do. That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it? Can't we just take the ribbon off?
No! His lips are sealed!
What?
You can't! Just stay back! You can't do that!
Slow down. It's all right. I'm not gonna do anything.
Please, don't.
Okay. I get it. So the ribbons, if you take them off... Sorry, I wish I could do something.
If anyone finds out I came here...
That's probably Snow.
Listen, Sheriff. Can you keep this conversation between us? I could be in a lot of trouble. I shouldn't be talking to you.
I won't tell anyone, don't worry.
Thank you.
Sorry, I just need to talk to the sheriff for a moment. Please excuse us.
1 minute.
I might have a new lead for you, but I don't know how solid it is. Beauty and Beast called the office just now. They said they wanted to talk to you about something. I wonder if they've heard about Crane.
Thank you for listening, Sheriff. You should go on to your next business. I don't think you'll be wasting your time.
Wait, you don't have to go. That was... abrupt.
It's one way to send a message.
What did she tell you? I didn't mean to rush her out. Did you get anything from her?
She told me enough. I think she told both of us with the way she just left.
Okay then. Good work. So, about Beauty and Beast. Do you think there's something to it? Is this the right place to look? What could they know about the Crooked Man? Or do you think they just heard about last night, and they're scared about what's been going on?
Beauty told me she had to take out a loan from the Crooked Man. Seems like a pretty bad deal.
I can only imagine what they're thinking now. We need to solve this before something else happens. Who knows what? I have other matters to attend to.
And you didn't want to tell me what you were into either.
Good reason. Look what happened.
So that's back on me now. I thought we agreed that was settled.
You said it was settled. That doesn't mean I have to agree.
Oh. What do you want? Well, you're just going around knocking on doors?
You called, right? Or, was it Beauty?
Why would I call you?
Listen, I've had a shitty night.
You think you're the only one?
And I really don't want to deal with the runaround. Snow said you called and wanted to talk to me.
Well, I didn't call. Must have been Beauty. She's been surprising me a lot lately.
Can I...
So have you. Bigby. Yet, with all the sneaking around and secrets, somehow I'm still the bad guy in this. I've had to hear about it all night long from her.
Who is it? Who's there?
Are you gonna let me in or what?
It's your pal, Bigby.
Hi, Bigby. Please excuse us for just a minute. Can I talk to you in private?
Yes, let's.
I guess I really do have the smallest apartment in the Woodlands.
I can already tell you're going to make a problem out of this.
What's he doing here? We don't need to bring him into this.
Beast.
I just don't think talk about living in the past.
He went behind my back. And then you run and call him again?
Well, I trust him.
Of course you do. He was keeping secrets for you.
It was one little thing. Do you want to keep fighting about that? Or do you want to try to sort this out?
All I'm saying is we can handle this on our own. You didn't have to bring it here.
We're out of money. And answers. That's why I called. We'll finish this later.
I know what the electric bill is for that thing.
Talk to Bigby.
Fine.
Sorry, it's been a long night.
Yeah, you know what they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta say, your place, it looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
Beast!
No, really, I want to know. What are you trying to say, huh?
Nothing. It's a nice place you got here.
Thanks, but that's really not why I called.
Is this something about that loan you took out? From the crooked man?
I didn't know what else to do, so...
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to complicate things.
I called him here, and I want to see if he can help us out. Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us.
Well, what kind of trouble are you in? Either it's the money, or it's something else.
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the crooked man? What if we talk, and you don't get him? And all this comes back on us. We'd be risking a lot. We've seen what happens when you cross the crooked man. And I don't know if it's worth it. If you can't give us certain assurances.
You are in danger. You two need to cooperate so I can get the crooked man off the street. You don't want to be next. But if you'd rather deal with this on your own...
No, please don't.
Then tell me what the fuck is going on. You're in so much debt? Look around you. This isn't the way people short on cash live.
Look, we're used to a certain kind of lifestyle, okay? We couldn't just give that up.
We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn, and we got in over our heads.
There's not a lot of work out there. Who would we be if we just lived like... Let me just,
A day at the beach?
Skiing the slopes?
And we can't come to the phone right now, so leave a message at the beep and we'll get back to you as soon as...
What the fuck was that?
Don't worry about it. Probably just a wrong number. Really, I think we're one digit off from some pizza place. Phone rings off the hook sometimes.
Fine. I'm sure you can handle whatever this is on your own. I'll see you later.
Please, Bigby. Wait. We've been getting horrible phone calls. It's the Crooked Man's people, trying to collect, and we aren't safe, even in our own home.
We owe some money.
Finally. All I care about is, how can I find the crooked man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The crooked man's behind that place. I'd overheard people talking to Jersey about loans before. So, when I needed money, that's where I went. I didn't know what to do.
You could have told me.
You had enough on your plate.
Who gets loans at a pawn shop anyway? What's really going on at this place?
The Crooked Man knows what people need to get by, so he provides. Besides, it didn't seem like such a bad deal when Jersey Devil was explaining it. I can see now that it was a mistake, but I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day. It was in a display case.
I guess he's hit hard times, too. There's a lot of that going around. I can't imagine he has a lot of marketable skills.
Sometimes, fables just don't have anywhere else to go.
What the hell are you doing hanging out at a place like the Lucky Pawn anyway?
Sometimes fables sell things they brought from the homelands. Things you can't find anywhere else.
You do know there's a difference between pawning something and selling it, don't you?
I know that.
You're buying a piece of someone else's misery. With money you don't have.
Well, that's over now. Maybe if you go there, you can sort some things out.
I guess I'll go check out the Lucky Pawn. If I can't track down the Crooked Man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the Crooked Man will come find me.
Hold on, Bigby. Don't go there. Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble. And... you know that butcher shop, the Cut Above? It's the place on Tubman Street. Same block as the baker and the candlestick maker. Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the Crooked Man. And I don't think it's meat in the packages. You gotta understand, I needed work.
You have to believe us. We didn't think it would get like this.
We're decent people, Bigby.
Well, what are you delivering? What's going on there? How does this fit into the Crooked Man's operation?
I couldn't tell you. But I do know this. It's the only meat market in town that doesn't carry filet. I'm not sure how much actual butchery goes on there.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the Butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me. She said I was reliable. She liked that. And it's the only thing I've been able to pick up, and it's still not enough. I don't want Beauty to have to work, especially not where she was.
It's Mary you deal with? Bloody Mary is there?
No. Johann is the one who hands over the packages, you know, day to day. But I've seen her around there. She gets under my skin, you know. I try to avoid her. But I don't need to tell you what she's like.
You're damn right you don't. I don't need a rundown on her reputation. If Mary works out of there, I need to look into it.
I just wanted to provide for Beauty. Give her the kind of life she deserves.
We shouldn't have to live like this, scraping to get by.
None of us should. We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle. All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home. You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
No, probably not.
So, where are you going? If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from.
I want to know what the Crooked Man is hiding at that butcher shop.
You know, Bigby, once you show up there, word is gonna spread. There may be nothing left for you to see if you go to the Lucky Pawn after.
Well, I guess I'll find out.
Wait, I don't know what you're planning to do when you find the Crooked Man, but is there any way you could help us out?
What do you mean?
Well, maybe you can make this all just go away.
We would really appreciate it. What do you say?
Can you help us out?
You're asking me to kill him, aren't you? Is that what you think I do?
No!
Of course not.
I don't know how you get that idea. We know that the Crooked Man is dangerous to all of Fabletown.
I'm gonna do my job. Lucky for you, that might just solve your problems anyway.
Oh, thank you, Bigby.
I'm sure you'll do the right thing.
He's got a whole lot of customers, or he doesn't have any. Right. Not very appetizing. Frozen solid. Who'd want to eat this?
Wolf?
Well, welcome, Sheriff. What can I get for you? You interested in a particular cut? Let's see. What do we have in stock? Let's see what we got here. Flank steak on special. New York strip. I can have some wild boar in tomorrow if you like. Sirloin. Ribs, roast, tongue. Got some tongue here.
Johan, I want to know exactly what's going on here.
We sell meat. Did you want to buy something? What you see is what you get. Just meat. You'll find anything else. We do more wholesale and meat packing than walk-up service. I'd like to help you. Really, I would. But there's nothing here.
So you don't mind if I take a look around?
I guess not. Sheriff, I... Did you hear that?
What?
Oh, I'm real sorry. Hold on. I just gotta go check on that. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
Butcher?
I just have to go see. Shit.
I got it covered back here, Sheriff. I'll be right out. But you're not supposed to be back here for safety purposes. Come on, damn it. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. They're gonna kill me. Oh, God, she is gonna fucking kill me. He's gonna get me killed. Things I do.
How you doing?
Please, Bigby. Please don't.
Bigby? What happened to Sheriff?
Please don't kill me, Sheriff. I don't want to die. Please.
Please don't kill me.
If you don't talk, I might have to do just that. Is that what you want, Johan?
No, no, please. You don't have to do that.
I'm dead. Either way, they said to me, Johan, you could keep your life and lose your shop, or lose both. What would you do? It was a simple choice to make in the moment.
Easy, even when they got you on a hook in the deep freeze.
They? Do you mean Mary? Bloody Mary?
This isn't my shop anymore. That crew took it from me a long time ago.
Crew?
Fuck. The Crooked Man's people. Jersey Devil, Dean Dumb, and that mental case Bloody Mary. You want to talk about the real butcher? It's her, not me. This is her place. I'm telling you, they muscled in on me. Took over my storage and delivery a long time ago.
All cause of that heat wave. That summer was even hotter than this one. Oh, I'd let Mary and those porkers stay cool in the meat locker one day, playing cards, having a great time. I guess they were sizing the place up. Shows what I get for being nice. I'm just a victim in this.
I don't know what they do back there. I swear. And I don't want to know.
Well, we're about to see what's back there. And then we'll see if I believe you.
I knew this would happen. Didn't know when. But there...
Shh. Is this place?
I told you, Bigby. I don't know. They muscled me out. I swear, I don't know anything more. I haven't been back here when it was like this.
Warning lights.
It's business. It's all I've ever had. I guess that's why I stuck around when they took it.
Damn it. You can't act like you're forced into this and then turn around and help them. Still be here if you hadn't flipped that switch out there.
I had to. Huh. You come in here making trouble for me. But you only give a shit now because the Crooked Man stepped on your toes or something. Where were you when they took this place from me? It hasn't been easy for me. You think I want to live with this at my back? I needed help. I needed your help.
You're not off the fucking hook yet, Butcher. If I find something, if I so much as smell something that makes me think you're lying. So this is what Beast was delivering. Glamours, other kinds of magic. Could be dangerous stuff. Looks like math or something. Shit. Is everybody on here? Do you know anything about this?
I don't know. A lot of fables out there need a lot of things. Maybe just don't touch anything back here, please.
That symbol. It's on all the packages. What is it?
That's the Crooked Man's, brand. It's on everything that goes in and out of here.
So you do know something, huh? Is that a wheel or what?
I guess they never used that thing on wolves, huh?
What's that supposed to mean?
It's from back in the homelands. A torture device. It came over here with the rest of our stories. Not that Mundys need any help coming up with that kind of thing. It makes people crooked. By breaking their bones and... Do I really need to explain this?
These are raw materials for making magic. Anti-Greenleaf and any other rogue witches out there probably get their supplies here. James, who's getting chained up here?
You can't think I'm the only one the Crooked Man has under his yoke.
Don't you see what's going on here? All these fables, getting magic from him. Business is booming. He's got all he needs. The raw materials, and the slave labor to process them. And with all this gear, looks like they could make just about any kind of magic. A lot of it. It's pretty clear why.
Oh, yeah? Why?
Doing it like this, it's bound to be cheaper than the 13th floor.
This is just horrible. Things that must have gone on here.
How the hell did all this happen? I didn't see it. Didn't stop it. This is a whole lot bigger than we thought. People just don't know the real cost of getting something cheap.
You don't have to tell me.
And that fucker, Crane, knew all about it.
Yeah, what about Crane? Finding the Crooked Man is so fucking important, why don't you ask your boss?
Snow?
No, Crane. He said he knows where everybody is. I don't know how, but he's got it some way. That's right. It was that creepy magic mirror with the big green head and all. Why don't you just use that? Find the Crooked Man that way. And leave me alone. Yeah, with stuff like that mirror, I'm surprised that you ever need to leave the office. Can't you just vaporize anyone who gives you trouble? Do it right from your living room. Smoking cigarettes with your feet up.
Crane shattered the mirror and made off with one of the pieces. He probably still has the shard with him.
Well, if they got their hands on an important magical item, there's only one place they'd take it. The Lucky Pawn. They probably took Crane there, too.
The Lucky Pawn. If I can find the mirror piece there, I can find the Crooked Man.
Hey, hold on. Well, I'm real happy you found what you're looking for, Bigby. What about me? Huh? What the hell am I supposed to do now? I'm gonna have to spend the rest of my short life looking over my shoulder for Bloody Mary. They won't care that I held up my end.
Report to the business office. Tell Snow I sent you there, and we'll figure something out. Some kind of protection.
Thank you. Thank you, Sheriff.
Jersey, don't give me that shit. What the fuck is the point of having a system if you're just gonna...
That's my fucking
Jack,
system.
What the fuck is going on?
But you,
I'm the guy to keep shit in order.
You know.
And that's it, Woody. If you love your ex so fucking much, why'd you pawn it in the first fucking place, huh?
I didn't pawn it, asshole. It was stolen from my apartment.
You don't want no part of this, pal. You push me one more time. So get the fuck out of my sight. Hit the bricks. See you later.
Hey, what's going on here?
What the fucking hell?
Christ. And this fucking guy, too?
Are you kidding me? It was here. It was right fucking here. What did you do with it?
How the fuck do I know?
Listen, you bald little dipshit. You're gonna... You piece of shit!
Pull it, Woody.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you. We don't need the business office involved in this shit. I just want what's mine. My axe.
What is your fucking problem?
Just stay out of my way, all right?
How you feeling today, Sheriff? Still looking for whoever killed them hookers? Or are you done chasing your tail?
Where's my axe? Who'd you give it to? This is my fucking fight.
Not now.
Dog, you got a lot of nerve.
Mirror's missing shard. Where is it? Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
You don't know anything about anything, do you? What do you have? Nothing. Had useless bitch Snow White in a broken fucking mirror. No fucking friends.
Nothing? I still have you, don't I?
You can't find a crooked man. No one can. Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot. You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror. They dumped all his shit here. Bloody Mary uses this place like a fucking dump.
Where's Crane's stuff? Where'd they put it?
In back. Just go on. Get Crane's shit and go. Not that it's gonna do you any good.
See anything?
Crane's coat. No time for traveler's checks, huh? He won't be needing this anymore. That sick piece of... The shard. It's the shard. Finally.
Hey, Sheriff. Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you can do to bring them back. And I don't know what they did, but I do know this. Oh, if they're dead, it's because the Crooked Man wanted them dead. That's all it takes. So you can roar smash the place up. Shit. You can wail on me all you want, but what good is it gonna do you? 'Cause he ain't in your town. You're in his, and he sure as shit is ready for you.